and a very warm welcome to our discussion today on collaboration within oncology and the benefits to cancer patients. My name is Hannah Wise. I'm a journalist and the moderator for our discussion today, and I'm delighted to be here at the Clinique Générale-Beaulieu, which is not only a centre of excellence, but it's also an historical institution here in Geneva, in Switzerland, and it's renowned for various things. We have orthopedic, general surgery, urology, gynecology, and maternity specialists, and it cares for over 5,000 patients every year. But perhaps most important and crucial to this discussion is that it is also home to a brand new cancer care centre, and it relies on specialists in all fields in oncology and surgery to really bring this multidisciplinary background to the care that is provided here. And it's also hyper-personalised care, and that really is the basis for our conversation today. So let me introduce you to our experts. Joining me today, we have Professor Oscar Matzinger. Hello. Welcome to you. You're a Medical Director for Radiation Oncology. Also with us today, Dr. Alex Friedlaender, who's a Medical Oncologist. Thank you as well for joining us.
Thank you, Hannah.
So really the key thing here is this idea of a multidisciplinary approach. Professor Matzinger, it sounds good, we know that it is a good solution, but what does it actually mean in practice for our patients?
So for our patients, it means that he has one door to enter to the clinic, and that we will make sure that he will get the best staging of the disease, and then that he will get the best proposal for our treatment. And that this will be discussed with the different specialists, as you said, the organ specialist like a urologist, for example, gynecologist, the medical oncologist, radiation oncologist, and that every situation will be discussed in this multidisciplinary approach to have really the best proposal for the patient.
And what's really interesting is that it's done in what's called a tumor board. So everyone actually gathers together at the same time to help make decisions and make decisions more quickly.
Absolutely. We meet every week and we see, review the images, the pathology, and every information we have about the patient. And together we propose the best solution for the patient.
Thank you very much. Dr. Friedlaender, can you bring us up to date perhaps then on some of the technologies and some of the cutting edge technologies that you're using at the moment?
Of course. So treatments have evolved just like the diagnosis has evolved. That's to say, a few decades ago, lung cancer was one disease. You could treat it with surgery when it was localized or chemotherapy when it was advanced. Today, the very disease diagnosis is no longer the same. Lung cancer became two diseases, three diseases, based on the type of cells involved, and now it became dozens of diseases based on genomic mutations, so mutations that drive the cancer to grow. And so today, when you have one of those mutations, you can give highly specific targeted therapy, usually oral therapy, which is less toxic and more effective than chemotherapy. And for a lot of the other patients with lung cancer, we now have immunotherapy, which unlocks the body's immune system to attack the cancer. We really have this choice of treatments to personalize therapy. And we also have the option of giving therapy with radiotherapy combined with chemotherapy, followed by immunotherapy. So we put all these treatment modalities together to give the best treatment to each patient.
And Professor Matzinger, what about what's going on in radiation oncology?
So in radiation oncology, we have only one active principle, which is radiation. And radiation kill the tumor cells, but they go through the body. And in the last 20 years, we had probably three generations of evolution in radiation therapy with the precision really to be able to target the tumor, the cancer cells, and to avoid the healthy cells not to have too much toxicity. So in our center, we are very happy because we have the most evolved machines, one which will be dedicated for complicated tumor volumes of a certain size, which is called a tomotherapy, and the other one is really for sub-millimetric precision, where we even speak about radiosurgery, and this machine is a cyber knife.
So this is very interesting because actually this hospital here is one of the few places in Switzerland where patients can access this kind of technology. Does that make this a teaching center?
Yes, absolutely. We are also a teaching center, and we host colleagues from Europe who want to get trained on the state of the art of the treatment with those kind of machines. And we will also soon have a new teaching center where people around the world will be trained on those techniques.
So we know in general, Dr. Friedlaender, that cancer treatments have evolved over time, but how does this collaborative approach really benefit patients?
Well, the collaboration starts with the diagnosis, so staging. Today we have very, very good exams whether it's in radiology and nuclear medicine, and then the pathological analysis is very specific as well. So the diagnosis itself is more specific than it once was. And then based on the diagnosis and the stage of disease, we work together with different specialists like radio-oncologists or surgeons to offer an optimal treatment. For example, if we see a cancer that has only a few metastases, we'll want to give a systemic treatment, so something intravenous or oral, and then we'll often want to associate that with a localized treatment, such as radiotherapy, to increase the efficacy of what we're doing and prolong a patient's life.
Well, this must be of huge confidence to the patients.
Absolutely. So patients are very happy to know that we're doing everything we possibly can for them. And we want to offer them the best quality of life and prolong their life as much as possible.
We talked a little bit about lung cancer earlier, but Professor Matzinger, prostate cancer is one of the most common cancers among men. Does radiotherapy increase recovery chances compared to surgery? And when would you use surgery?
In localized prostate cancer, we now have the evidence that radiation therapy is as efficient as surgery. So in some situation, we could propose surgery to the patient, a younger patient, for example, where we want to avoid radiation. But in many situations, we can propose both modalities, and the patient should choose which one he prefers.
So the patients are very involved in their treatment?
Absolutely. In those situations, the patient should meet with a surgeon and with a radiation therapist and then make his own decision.
And tell me, what kind of patients do you see?
So we see a lot of patients from Switzerland, from the area of Geneva, of course, but we have also a lot of international patients. They like to be in Geneva, and it's very convenient for radiation therapy, which is an outpatient setting, to come to the clinic for half an hour a day, for example, and to be the rest of the time in Geneva.
And Dr. Friedlaender?
So yes, I would agree with Oscar. A lot of our patients are local patients from Switzerland or nearby France. Then we also have international patients who come here to be able to do everything in one spot. So the fact that we have the latest radiation, oncology, radiology, nuclear medicine, and then for us, oncologic treatments, allows patients to come here and receive treatments they may not be able to receive elsewhere, while being in a comfortable setting and in a comfortable city.
Well, that's all we have time for. Thank you very much indeed, Professor Matzinger and Dr. Friedlaender. And thank you. I hope you have found today's discussion insightful. Thanks for watching.